Good morning, my dear students. I hope you all are fine and doing well in your study. As your half yearly exam has been over now, so let's focus on unit test second that is going to be held in December 2020. So children, today we are going to start chapter 18, that is fuels. So let's focus on the contents that we are going to cover in this chapter. Introduction of fuels. Fossil fuels, coal, petroleum, natural gas, vehicles without fuel, uses of fuels, conservation of fuels, alternative sources of energy, and home assignments. So, first topic is introduction of fuels. Children, you all are having bikes, cars, scooters, and many more vehicles. As well as all, you all have seen many vehicles around you. Do you know, children, how do these vehicles are run? Yes, you must be knowing that these vehicles are run either from diesel, petrol or CNG. CNG, that is also known as compressed natural gas. Do you know, children, what are these known as? These are called fuels. So, a fuel is a source of energy. It produces energy when burnt. Petrol, diesel, kerosene, coal, liquefied petroleum gas that is also known as LPG and compressed natural gas that is also known as CNG are some fuels. They are used in vehicles for cooking and for producing electricity. So children, to save the world, let's learn about one of natural best gifts to humanity that helped us to grow, develop and live in efficient life. That is known as fossil fuels. So our next topic is fossil fuels. So children, tell me, what are fossil fuels? Coal, petroleum and natural gas are fossil fuels. They are formed from the remains of ancient plants and animals buried deep inside the earth millions of years ago. They are non-renewable sources of energy. Can you tell me, children, what are non-renewable resources? Yes, non-renewable resources are exist in fixed amounts. That is, fossil fuels such as coal, oil, natural gas and nuclear energy. So, I am going to explain more about fossil fuels. Decomposing plants and other organisms buried beneath layers and sediment and rock have taken millennia to become the carbon-rich deposits we now call fossil fuels. Children, you see, a long time ago, our beautiful earth was covered with swamps filled with various microorganisms, trees and other large leafy plants. And as these organisms and plants died, they drowned to the base of the swamps and oceans and formed layers of spongy materials called peat. Over millions of years, the peat was covered by sand, clay and other minerals which converted the peat into sedimentary rock. Children, listen very carefully and understand the story of fossil fuels. Then over the next few years, different types of fossil fuels formed depending on the combination of organic matter present, how long it was buried and what temperature and pressure conditions existed when they were decomposing. And what are the types of fuels? Well, there are three types of fuels, namely coal, petroleum and natural gas. That supplies about 80% of the world's energy. These non-renewable fuels can be obtained through mining and extraction inside the land or huge ocean. So children, our next topic is that is the type of fossil fuels, that is coal. Coal is found deep under the earth's surface. It is a solid fossil fuel and is the largest source of energy on the earth. It is also used in factories for making iron and steel and other goods. Coal is obtained by digging deep inside the earth. This is known as coal mining, In India, coal is found in Jharkhand, West Bengal, Odisha, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. The major coal mines in India are in Bokaro, Dhanbad, Jharia, Raniganj and Korba. Coal was used in angichis to cook food and to keep homes warm during winter in the olden days. Next, petroleum. Petroleum is a type of crude mineral oil. It is also known as black gold. It is formed from the remains of plants and animals buried under the sea or land for millions of years. Petroleum reservoirs in India are found in Mumbai Highfield, located off the coast of Mumbai, Digboi and Sivasagar in Assam, and Ankleshwar and Khambhat in Gujarat. Here I am going to explain more about petroleum. Here is a story of petroleum. So, let's start the story. This story starts millions of years ago, even before dinosaurs existed. Children, listen very carefully about the story of petroleum. It came from the remains of plants and animals that lived in water. When plants and animals died, their remains stayed bottom of the seabed. Slowly and gradually, their remains were covered with layers and layers of sand and silt. The pressure and heat from the ground reacted with the remains and turned them into crude oil. Crude oil looked like smelly and looked like yellow-black liquid, as you can see in this picture. Did you know, children, crude oil is also known as petroleum, which means rock oil. Since crude oil is found in the seabed, people have to drill to the sea to extract oil. After they taken out the oil from the ground, it's sent to the refinery to long pipes or through a ship. Here are world's top 5 crude oil name producing countries that are Saudi Arabia, Russia, United States, Iran and China. Did you know, children, that there are many oil refineries in India that are Chennai, Assam, Jamnagar in Gujarat, Guwahati, Mumbai and Visakhapatnam. Crude oil can be used to make gasoline, that is also known as petrol, diesel oil and even electricity. Next, natural gas. Natural gas is found along with petroleum in oil wells. It is used as a domestic and industrial fuel. It is considered a clean fuel as it does not cause pollution. It is cheaper than petrol and diesel. CNG can be supplied directly from gas fields through pipelines. Vadodara in Gujarat and some parts of the National Capital Region have this network of pipelines. Next topic, vehicles without fuel. The meaning of vehicles without fuel is the vehicles that does not cause any type of pollution. In earlier times, people would walk long distances. Palanquins were used to carry kings or queens from one place to another. Then came bicycles, rickshaws and vehicles like tangas and bullock carts. Rickshaws were drawn and cycles were ridden by humans to travel short distances. Tangas and bullock carts were drawn by animals to travel longer distances. These type of vehicles does not cause any type of pollution. Next, uses of fuels. Fuel is used for many purposes. First, petrol is essential for transportation. It is used in cars, school buses, trucks and other vehicles. Diesel is widely used as fuel for vehicles such as tractors, trailer trucks, buses, boats and trains. LPG is an eco-friendly fuel used at home and in some vehicles. Coal is used as a fuel in factories. It used for generating electricity. CNG is used as a fuel for vehicles. It is especially used in public transport as it is cheaper. Kerosene is used as a fuel for cooking, lighting and heating. Paraffin wax, that is a byproduct of petroleum, is used to make candles. Next, How can we conserve fuels? So our topic is conservation of fuels. Children, there is a limited supply of fossil fuels on the earth. Coal, petroleum and natural gas take millions of years to form. Therefore, conserving these fuels is very important. The following steps can be taken to conserve fuels. Carpooling can help us conserve fuel. What is the meaning of carpooling? Carpooling means sharing rides with friends, family or even neighbors. Using public transport and local trains also saves fuels. Turning off car engine when the car is not moving conserves fuel. Using bicycles and rickshaws for traveling short distances saves fuel. Walking to nearby places instead of using cars or motorcycles not only reduces pollution but also reduces the amount of fuel used. These are the steps that we should be taken to conserve fuels. Next topic is alternative sources of energy. Children, there are many alternative sources of energy on the earth. We get solar energy from the sun, that is also known as renewable resources because it is naturally replenished. Geothermal energy from the earth and wind energy from wind. These are called renewable resources or alternative sources of energy because they are available to us in large quantities and can be replenished. By using these, we can conserve non-renewable resources of energy. Non-renewable resources that I have already told are fixed in limited amounts. Non-renewable resources are found in limited amounts. Biogas is produced from waste materials and used as a cooking fuel. Sunlight or solar energy can be used directly for heating and lighting homes, streets and other buildings, and heating water. It also has a variety of commercial and industrial uses. So, children, as our dependency on these fuels kept on increasing, humans began to use them recklessly without considering that these fuels are non-renewable sources of energy, which does not develop in a day or two, but takes millions of years to form. Yes, my dear students, I know it is hard to believe, but fossil fuels we use today started creating from the Carboniferous period, which is even before the existence of dinosaurs. Yes, therefore, if we use this energy carelessly, today we are going to land into a devastating problem as the new fuel will take another million years to form again. Yes, my dear students, if we continue to use and burn these fuels at this rate, they also have the potential to harm the environment as they are made up of harmful chemical bonds that could be dangerous for us. So we must use wisely these fossil fuels. So I think, children, you all have understood about this chapter. If you have any problem, go through the video, write your query there. You can ask your question in WhatsApp group also. So now it's time for some homework. Here are some difficult words. You have to write it in your rough copy. And one question is there. You have to find the answer and learn it. Difficult words are fuel, gradually, reservoirs, judiciously, palanquins, paraffin, alternative, geothermal, replenished, commercial. Question: do all vehicles consume an equal amount of fuel per unit of distance? Thank you to all children.